Hello friends, welcome back to Cool School. Myself and Suman are back again with another video on cricket. As you all know, we already made a video about our favorite 11 in ODI matches, right?
Correct.
From the past 20 games.
Yes.
Yeah, so we are back again with another video on our favorite 11 in Test matches.
Test matches. Yes.
From the past 20 games.
Yeah.
Right. So, in fact, we both have picked the same 11, okay? Exactly the same 11.
It's quite interesting.
It's very interesting, actually. Yeah, because compared to our ODI 11, it was very different. We picked a different 11.
Correct.
Yeah. However, few players were same, but but in this Test 11, we have picked the same. Okay. So it is going to be a shorter video than the earlier one. So coming to the openers. Yeah. So we are picking
Virendra Sehwag
and Matthew Hayden. Yeah.
Yeah, so talking about Virendra Sehwag, we know how fearless a cricketer he is. Zero. So when he plays, it is very difficult to contain him. So he goes on score big runs, and 200s, 300s, it's not a big matter to him.
Right.
So even if he plays for a single day also, he can score 200 runs. That's the amount of runs he scores.
Right. He made 300 runs, you know, look very easy.
Very easy. Huh?
Yeah, he made it look very easy.
Yeah. One more thing about is that when he plays with that kind of aggressiveness,
right.
So the team score would be like, you know, 400 runs and more
in just a single day. The opposition will be very, you know, fearsome about it.
Because, you know, there are only 4 days left, and one more thing, the result would be, you know.
Will already be in, you know, in our hands. In our hands. If, you know, when an opener scores like this, actually I think he made the test format totally look different, right? I mean, earlier what we used to think was test matches means, you know, it will be very slow.
Most of the matches were in a draw.
Yeah, in a draw. It takes place for 5 long days, and it's really boring. Yeah, that was the kind of feeling we used to have. I mean, it's not boring actually. It's not a right word. But he changed the way, you know, everyone looks at the test matches.
Yes.
So
he's a very good entertainer.
Very good entertainer. When he's on the crease, you know, runs, you know, keep flowing. The way he clears the ground, the way he clears the 30-yard circle in the beginning overs, it's really remarkable.
With his, hand-eye coordination.
Yeah,
especially not much of footwork. Yes. It's very unique technique for Virendra Sehwag.
Correct. Especially towards the offside, the way he, you know, he cuts the ball
towards square and, you know, hitting sixes at the square. It's quite remarkable for Virendra Sehwag.
Right.
So once Ganguly said that he has rated him very high. In Test cricket.
Right. Of ODI. Head of many greats.
Yes, definitely. He is really a match winner.
Right.
So when it comes to the opening slot.
Yeah, that's why we have Virendra Sehwag in Test match, Test 11, and not in the ODI.
ODI.
He's good in ODI also, but we are not keeping him there in the
especially in the first innings of ODI Test cricket.
Yeah.
He is the most destructive player of all time.
Absolutely. First innings average is really remarkable.
Right. His average is more than 70, I think.
Yeah.
So let's talk about Matthew Hayden.
Matthew Hayden. We have with him is Matthew Hayden. Yeah, who was really, really destructive. Who started his career very late. Otherwise, he would have been, more successful, with the number of runs.
Yeah.
So considering him playing alongside Adam Gilchrist for Australia, so he's another destructive player. So he knows how to play alongside a destructive player. Right?
How to pace the innings and how to build the innings and how to build a platform.
Yeah, along with the destructive player. So we have Virendra Sehwag, who is also similar to, you know, Adam Gilchrist. So we can say Matthew Hayden can
matches,
also play well.
Matches well with Virendra Sehwag. This is the one more thing. Why
and
we have picked
Matthew Hayden, and it's a good left-hand return combination as well.
Yes.
Yeah, and Matthew Hayden, particularly in tests, has a very good record compared to his ODI.
Correct.
Format, right? Yeah. So he has scored 380 runs.
Highest score. He has beaten
that time it was the highest score because by beating Brian Lara.
Brian Lara's
long time score was 375. Yeah, it was remarkable. 380 to score 380 in innings. It's not a joke. Yeah. So Virendra Sehwag and Matthew Hayden in the opening slots, and the next we have is
Rahul Dravid,
the wall of the game,
Mr. Dependable,
absolutely.
Captain's man, yeah.
exactly. Yeah. So, what to say about him? I mean, the way His patience, particularly, okay, the way he used
he's
to
a
build
team
up
man.
teams. Yeah.
Whenever the team needs him, he always comes up and you know, achieve score runs and you know, he takes his team out of trouble many of the time, many occasions. That's why he called him as Ball.
The ball.
So very very difficult situation. Ball is moving around everywhere. So in that conditions also, he used to keep the wicket
right.
one end and seeking that one end
right,
and
right.
you know. Taking team out of the trouble. He's, you know, has done many occasions.
Right.
That's the reason why he's regarded as the
wall of the game and very Mr. Dependable in all, even in ODIs, he was
ODIs.
Dependable in that
yes.
slot
mm.
and in tests especially, wow, he was simply great and in all conditions, you know, not just in subcontinent conditions. He used to play well, you know, in the fast tracks as well, like
mm.
in Australia,
correct.
England and, and
mm.
South Africa as well.
Even the best of the best have struggled in
right.
those conditions,
right, right.
but he has, you know, done remarkably well for
remarkably well. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Such a gift for Indian cricket.
Yeah, yeah.
So also with his technique,
technique
he's
the footwork,
textbook player, complete
textbook player,
complete
textbook
player.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Great for all the youngsters. You know,
yeah.
to follow.
You can follow. Yes.
Right,
any
right.
youngster can follow Rahul Dravid and become a great success.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. And yeah, his you know his. Consistency in scoring well in second innings
mm-hmm.
compared to his first innings.
Yes,
was also a remarkable feat actually.
Correct.
So he was very reliable, especially in second innings actually.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So while chasing the game, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Also, yeah, while setting the score also.
Mm-hmm.
So he has this unique record, right?
He has a unique record of you know having an average of more than 50.
Mm-hmm.
In both the first innings and second innings.
Innings,
and moreover,
mm-hmm.
The second innings average is more compared
more
to the first innings.
The first innings.
This is very unique record. I don't think anybody
yeah.
in the world
yes.
is having this kind of records.
In test matches,
in
mean,
test
matches, wow,
yeah,
really,
yeah,
unique. Really.
So he's also you know contributing in India's you know under 19 team. He's always
right.
with the team,
right.
and you know he's growing up the youngsters
mm-hmm.
and everywhere.
Right.
And
right.
just a great asset to the team.
Correct.
So hope we can you know
mm-hmm.
build more players to the team and we can bring more talent to
yeah.
Indian cricket.
Yeah, and he was not bad in 2020 also. Right? It was
yeah, definitely he was the one who succeeded
yeah.
pretty well compared
yeah.
to other players.
The right. rates. Correct, correct, correct.
Yeah.
Yeah. So and the number four slot now in the test matches. Yeah, we had to leave out many great players like you know, Sachin Tendulkar,
mm-hmm.
Jack Kallis.
Very difficult decision. I think
Kumar
this particular spot.
Yeah, we had to leave out many Damien Martin. Michael Clark, yeah, but we are keeping just one who is a genius of the game,
stylish
player of the game, left-handed genius from West Indies, Brian Lara.
Hmm.
Yeah, so
I mean, talk about Brian Lara and his stylish play and all.
Yeah, his stance, the way he you know he plays the ball with such you know. With such you know, elegance, wow,
mm.
it's simply great. And his performance, especially in the test matches, are really good. He has set the highest score in an innings, which was 375, which stood for a long time. And then, as you said, Michael Hayden beat it by scoring 380.
Yes.
And Renner was back again,
scored 400.
400 not out.
400
yes.
not out.
Wow.
He still is the.
Yeah, he has
best
highest score
highest
in
in
a
test cricket.
In a test cricket, Indian innings.
Right?
Yeah. 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 So and he was the captain also, right?
Captain
West Indies.
Correct.
So yeah, now the number fifth slot, yeah, is our number fifth player also in the ODI, which
yes.
is who is
AB
de Villiers. Yeah. So
very difficult player to leave out.
Right, right. Like you said in our other video, he can play well in all the three formats of the game. So we are picking him in test matches also. His highest score in test match was 278.
Yeah.
Or something. Yeah. So he can do well here also. So he has a very good average in both away and home matches. Yeah, it's truly remarkable.
Yeah.
How can we leave him out?
Yeah. So it's very.
His ability to read the game, right?
Yeah.
It's so good. Yeah, so that's about AB in number 5th. And so in number 6th, we have a wicket-keeping batsman from Zimbabwe, right?
Andy Flower.
Who is none other than Andy Flower, the most successful player from Zimbabwe. Yeah, and he was very good in the middle order in terms of scoring, you know, big runs.
Most dependable batsman.
Yeah, most dependable batsman for Zimbabwe. And
Zimbabwe, in fact, relied more mainly on Andy Flower.
Right, at that time. And he was a great sweeper of the ball. His ability to naturally sweep the ball and also to reverse sweep it. Was really great.
He's one of the best sweepers.
Yeah, one of the best. Right, really great. For his sweeping and also, you know, his general play. It was great. And he later on went on to coach the England national team also. Yeah, so we had to keep him in this team as a wicket-keeping batsman. And now for the number 7 slot,
we have an all-rounder.
An all-rounder from
England.
So
who is Freddie Flintoff.
Andrew Flintoff, right. So Andrew Flintoff, he was, I would call him a bowling all-rounder for his, you know, great ability in the bowling.
Very handy with the bat as well.
Yeah.
So especially his strength lies with his bowling.
Lies in bowling, yeah. So his the kind of responsibility he used to take, though he was an all-rounder, the kind of responsibility he used to take in the bowling department, okay, by taking crucial wickets was really
crucial
great,
times
yeah.
And pressure situations he used to deliver for
right.
England is quite remarkable.
Right. He was the captain's go-to guy, the Michael Vaughan's go-to bowler in terms of taking crucial wickets at the crucial points of the game.
He's a rhythmic bowler. Once he gets going,
mm-hmm.
so then it's very difficult to stop him.
Yeah.
Keep on taking wickets crucial times.
Yeah, very aggressive. It is by sledging also.
Yeah. His body language itself is, you know, something to, you know, look for.
Right, and his success in Ashes also phenomenal.
Because as we all know, in Ashes it's a very
pressure situation.
So it's very, very difficult for any players to score runs or even to, you know, take wickets.
Yes.
You know? So in those situations as well, the Andrew Flintoff delivered and very successful in Ashes and in all test matches especially.
Right. So he had to be there in the team in number 7 slot as an all-rounder, and in number 8, number 10th was very easy. We have Shane Warne in number 8, and in number 9th we have Muthiah Muralidharan, and in number 10th we have the fast bowler Glenn McGrath. Okay, we have spoken already about these three guys in our ODI 11. Okay.
Greatest player of all time.
Greatest players, they are really greatest players of all time. So we have to keep them in the list 11 also.
They have set the benchmark for other players to follow.
That's why we have them.
Easy call for us to, you know, take for 8th, 9th and 10th position.
Correct. Yeah.
So
and
nobody
sure.
is better than them.
Right. So I'm sure they will be there in the many people's playing 11
playing
also.
Yeah.
So that leaves us to the number 11 slot. So which is none other than Wasim Akram. Okay. With about whom also we have spoken about in our previous video, ODI 11 team.
Mm-hmm.
So one thing I guess I left out is once Wisden in 2002 regarded Wasim Akram as the greatest bowler of all time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, by keeping him ahead of other greats like Walker Yunus, you know, Glenn McGrath, Muthiah Muralidharan. You know.
Yes.
That speaks really volumes, and Wasim Akram deserves it. So
yes.
He is there in our. So this is our test 11. So in short, we have the openers Virender Sehwag, Matthew Hayden, and Rahul Dravid.
Yes.
Brian Lara.
Yeah.
Who is the captain of our 11? Okay. Brian Lara.
Yes.
Keeping him as the captain. And number 5th, AB de Villiers. Number 6th, we have Andy Flower. Number 7th is the all-rounder Andy Flintoff. And in number 8th, we have Shane Warne, Muthiah Muralidharan, Glenn McGrath, and in the 11th, we have Wasim Akram. So that's all from this video about.
Hope you all enjoyed this video,
right? Yeah, and please leave us your opinion about our 11, our picks, and please comment down below your pick for your test 11. So we are happy to see that, and we will have discussion in the comment section.
Yeah.
So thank you so much, guys, for watching, and keep watching Cool School. Bye.
Okay. Bye.